Congratulations on your award nomination.
Thank you.
It's pretty exciting.
It's very exciting, yeah.
So how familiar were you with Dick's past before taking on the role?
I wasn't familiar with his past. I do recall, you know, with the first Gulf War, of seeing him as Secretary of Defense. But I didn't know anything about him prior to that. You know, you'd heard about Halliburton, et cetera, and then I'd obviously seen him. VP, and you knew that he was apparently the puppet master with that. But there was a great deal of research that I had to do. And he's a very mysterious individual, you know, and with any person, you know, anybody that you're playing. You can only hope to just skim the surface, you know. You've got 2 hours to tell somebody's life story. It's impossible. You know, you just have to cherry pick.
It was a pretty strong POV about his life. It's a little daunting playing somebody that's still alive.
I've done it a couple of times. Mm-hmm. I actually quite enjoy it. The difference being I've always gotten to meet the people previously. So they've been able to express their feelings about my performance. You know, some of that positive, some of it not so happy. And I always feel like that's sort of an honorable thing to do. This was a different situation, though, with him being a public figure. And I was asked to please not reach out to him, which was a shame. But you know, we had well, as the beginning of the film says, with an expletive, we tried our best to get the facts right.
Tell us a little bit about transforming into this character from the weight gain to, you know, the prosthetics.
It all kind of happened in tandem, you know. As I'm reading and I'm watching and listening to him endlessly, you know, I'm just starting to eat more and put on weight, and I really wanted to build up my neck because it gives you that sort of sense of being like an immovable object, you know. And he's very definitely like that mentally. Mm-hmm. You know, he's very hard line. He's very assured of himself, and he certainly never backs down. You know, I mean, to this day, he never expresses any regret, any changes. He always says, "I would do it again in a minute, no matter how unpopular." That you got to make unpopular decisions, you know, as a leader. And so it all gradually happened, and then just sort of we understood. Okay, I got to get rid of the eyebrows. I got to shave my head, and then the wonderful work of the makeup and prosthetic team of Greg Canham and Chris Gallagher, who just did. Amazing job.
The transformation was pretty
yeah, and
amazing.
That ain't just me. That's a whole lot of us doing that.
And you and Amy are old friends. She told me a story of you had a bet going with the Shakespearean scene of who could learn their lines fastest, or do you remember that?
Yeah. We did a lot more Shakespeare. We filmed a lot more Shakespeare than ended up in the film.
Okay.
So what you see is actually just the tip of the iceberg of what we actually filmed. So we had a lot that we had to learn. And actually, that was something I tend to work best with a deadline or with money on the line.
Absolutely.
Competition. So I appreciated throwing down the gauntlet.
That's funny. And how did your family, your wife, your children react when they saw you in that transformative role?
It's interesting, you know. My son, he just doesn't bat an eyelid, you know, no matter what different guises he sees me in, different photographs. I think he must just look straight to the eyes because he doesn't comment on size or boldness or anything. He just goes, "Daddy, Daddy, Daddy, Daddy," just doesn't hesitate, you know. And he just used to like bouncing on my tummy, which he disappointed I don't have anymore.